A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Stop judging, that you may not be judged." For as you judge, so you will be judged. And the measure with which you measure will be measured out to you. Why do you notice the splendor in your brother's eye, but not perceive the wooden beam in your own eye? How can you say to your brother, "Let me remove the splendor from your eye," while the wooden beam is in your eye? You hypocrites. Remove the wooden beam from your eye first, then you will see clearly to remove the splendor from your brother's eye. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you,
Lord. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
When I first came here,
and respond.
The truth is that being judgmental of others causes far more harm to the one who judges than to the one who is being judged. Certainly, being judged is not pleasant, but the act of being judged by others is not a sin. If others judge you, and you are being judged, it's not a sin in your heart, but the person judging. However, the act of judging others is a sin, and it can be a great sin. This sin gives the one who judges with an empty and hungry heart. Love is lost in the soul who judges. If these words seem unpleasant, that's because they are. But sometimes we need to face the unpleasant truth in order to change. The cross was unpleasant, but it was also the greatest act of love ever known. Facing our sin of judgmentalness is unpleasant, but doing so is the only way to be free. Honesty to ourselves is an act of love given to God, to ourselves and to those whom we need to stop judging. Know the person before you judge. Not of what you see, not of what you hear, but of what you experience within.